Hi everyone, it's James here from Studiospares. In the last 18 months, Avid have brought out two new audio interfaces. First, we had the MTRX Studio, a 1U HDX and Dante compatible interface. And now, Avid are bringing us this baby, the new Pro Tools Carbon, which brings the power and dependability of Pro Tools HDX into a new breed of audio interface designed for creatives, artists, songwriters, and bands alike. Let's take a closer look. Pro Tools Carbon is Avid's answer to a modern combined host processing and advanced DSP workflow. Onboard, we find HDX DSP acceleration with 8 HDX DSP chips and a custom-made super-fast FPGA, which is great for both the processing of real-time effects as you record, and Carbon can assign that DSP to help handle massive mix session plugin counts. Avid call this their hybrid engine. When you use DSP mode, all associated tracks like sends and buses are also flipped into this mode to ensure a low latency recording experience. Pro Tools Carbon offers 25 in and 34 out simultaneous I/O, including 8 ultra transparent padless mic pres and 6 variable impedance inputs for instruments over quarter inch jack. We also get 4 independently configurable headphone outputs. Beauty is not just skin deep on this thing. We get double precision Jet PLL implemented clocking and top spec A to D D2A converters, as you might expect. The more observant of you might have noticed that there's something missing from the back panel of Pro Tools Carbon. No, your eyes are not deceiving you. There are no USB, Thunderbolt, or Avid Mini Digilink ports. Pro Tools Carbon is connected to your host Mac via its Ethernet port. More specifically, it uses the AVB AES67 compatible protocol to connect your Mac, that's your Mac, running macOS 10.15.6 or newer, to the Pro Tools Carbon interface. Use the included Cat6 Ethernet cable to link from port 1 on the back of Carbon to the Ethernet port on your Mac. If your Mac does not have a built-in Ethernet port, you can use the approved Apple Thunderbolt to Ethernet converter. However, many of the less premium priced Ethernet to Thunderbolt adapters do not support AVB and should be avoided at all costs. The connection should also be direct and not via a switch or hub. It's now time to power on your Pro Tools Carbon interface and your computer. You can check to see if your Mac is seeing your Pro Tools Carbon in the network system preferences. Carbon will show up orange with a self-assigned IP. Now open your Audio MIDI Setup application and head to the Window drop-down menu and open up Network Device Browser. Pro Tools Carbon should appear and make sure you tick the box to enable it. The net indicator on the front of Pro Tools Carbon should now light up. You will also now see two sets of outputs in Audio MIDI Setup, PT Carbon I/O and PT Carbon reserved for Pro Tools. If you see this, it's all good and we can carry on. If you wish, you can now make Pro Tools Carbon the default interface for your system sounds, including iTunes and video playback. In my experience, this is the first time a Pro Tools interface has played nicely with the macOS sound settings, meaning you can have your system sounds and Pro Tools running through the same interface at the same time. We can now launch Pro Tools, making sure that we're running at least version 2020.11 or newer. And we can assign the Pro Tools Carbon as our playback device in the playback engine. You'll be glad to hear you only have to go through this process once. If you need to disconnect your computer from your Pro Tools Carbon, your computer will automatically find the Carbon interface next time you attach it. So that's the setup done. Let's take a look at the front and back panels of the new Pro Tools Carbon interface. Starting on the far left, under the really very sexy glowing Avid logo, we find 2 of the 6 variable Z or variable impedance instrument inputs. Next to this, we find the main power button for the unit, as well as indicators showing network status and external clocking. Then we find the input controls. We can cycle through the 8 built-in mic pres. We can set the input type, be that mic, line or instrument. Mic and instrument inputs come from the XLR jack combos. Line level input comes from the D-sub. We'll get to that in a minute. We can set the input gain using the encoder. We can link channels where appropriate to create a stereo input, invert the polarity of a channel, turn on 48 volt phantom power, and we can engage talkback. When we have the instrument or mic inputs assigned, we have access to what Avid are calling variable Z. These five color-coded settings can change the way a virtual guitar amp feels to the player, or how a mic reacts to the slight variation in load. This can be most noticeable when recording using ribbon mics. There's no real right or wrong here, just try and experiment with your favorite gear and come up with some amazing tones. This is a classic case of Avid learning from their success with the 11 rack, which featured the True Z input for better matching of your guitar and effects to the input loading of the amp or effects chain. Next to the 8 channels of input or output monitoring over these rather lovely 9 segment LEDs, we find the main stereo master LED level indicators and the output section. Carbon can assign and control 3 sets of stereo outputs for monitors and 4 sets of stereo headphones. Again, we can scroll through these with the output encoder. Hitting the monitor output button again turns it red, indicating these outputs have been muted. Finally, on the far right of the front panel, we have the 4 stereo headphone output jacks. Around the back of the Pro Tools Carbon, we find the 8 XLR jack combination inputs for our microphones and instruments. Inputs 5 through 8 are the inputs with variable Z capability. We then find 8 analog line ins over D-sub and 8 outs over D-sub. The first 2 pairs of outs on the D-sub form the alternate sets of speaker outs. We then find the main stereo outputs over balanced TRS quarter inch jacks, a configurable foot switch, BNC connectors for word clock, the main Ethernet ports for connection to our Mac or AVB network, 16 ADA optical I.O. over 2 sets of Toslink ports, and finally the power supply input. But remember, of course, that Pro Tools Carbon is only as good as the software that accompanies it. Carbon ships with a 1-year subscription and an attached perpetual license, 116 AAX, of which 70 are AAX DSP plugins, which include the Avid Complete Bundle, a 5.4GB library of samples and loops, which can be very handy to fill in on the occasional gaps in our creativity, as well as premium plugins from Arturia, Brainworks, McDSP, Native Instruments, and UVI. Pro Tools Carbon, to my mind, is Avid's most feature-rich interface for the music creation market since the 11 rack over 12 years ago, back in 2009. There is easily enough I.O. to track a small band, and if you add a pair of 8-channel ADAT-equipped mic pres, you're going to get 25 simultaneous channels of input, enough for the most demanding of studio projects. Also, from a design and styling point of view, Avid have finally caught up with the competition from the likes of Antelope Audio and Universal Audio to produce a unit that's going to look fantastic in your rack or on your desktop. I think it's fair to say that Pro Tools Carbon is probably not going to be someone's first interface, but when you're ready to take a massive step up in your audio production quality, Pro Tools Carbon has to be a serious contender for your hard-earned cash. So I really hope you enjoyed this brief look at the new Avid Pro Tools Carbon interface. If you need any more help or advice, please do give the team at Studiospares a call or check out the website, studiospares.com. But for now, my name's James Ivey, and I'll see you again very soon.